head of me. They are ahead of me. So just before I start, two things I wanted to know. All our engineers, how many are 100% be engineers here? You are non-engineer. 100% engineers, so which is that. Most of them. And how many are pursuing undergraduate education? That means who are still in part of B.Tech or B. Can you raise your hands, please? Master, huh?
Largely masters.
Largely masters, okay. So how many are doing masters? Okay, that's another question. Oh, so you're senior people, huh? Masters in technology, which is there. And how many are in the management stream, which is also masters, which is there? Oh, so majority are in the management stream. Okay. So I'm speaking to more people in the management stream. So management stream would contribute 50% of the audience? Okay. So you know, because one thing I realized in marketing, you must know your target market and target audience before you start speaking. Whom are you talking to? So that's one thing which I learned. So a very generous introduction given. You know, when I generally get very conscious of introductions given because I don't deserve so many things which I said about me. So you know, I started my career 15 days before India won the World Cup, 83. So that's how old I am. So although you mentioned 83, so I remember I bunked my 15 days I was in the job and I fell ill. I told my boss that I'm not well and there's some very urgent work also. And next day I became, he says, you're looking at the TV on the World Cup, which is there. So sometimes you get caught in the very first instance. So what I'm going to talk today about are two, three things. My topic is basically how you can kickstart building your corporate brand, your brand, your corporate career, and building your individual brand. Now you say, how do you kickstart your corporate career when you are still in college or you are still working or still about to enter? But I believe this is the time to start building. And I personally believe that each one of you is a brand in themselves. Can anybody tell me, I'll have a lot of questions. Is it possible to get some toffees or chocolates so we can give to people who give right answers? Is it possible? Can somebody arrange, although I'm at a short notice, some toffees or chocolates, not expensive chocolates, not Mondial chocolates. Just a sign of recognition. Not that it is very important. So, first of all, I'd like to know what is a brand you understand by? And since all you people are management, somebody has to give me a definition of what is a brand. I want people to answer. So, whoever wants to answer, please raise their hands and yeah, please do.
Offering from a known source.
Known source, okay. Anybody else would like to add to this?
Brand is an image in mind of a person.
Brand is an image. That's an image and identity. Anybody else?
Brand is a differential factor which differentiates you from other
people. Okay. Well said. It actually combines all the things which you say. Now, I am saying that you are yourself a brand. Now you say, why here? I am not a brand. Anybody done finance in management? Finance to karaya hoga, you can't have management without finance. And so if people are raising their hands, there's an issue. Tell me, what is an intangible asset? Intangible asset. Can anybody answer? Please raise your hand. Yeah, ma'am.
Yeah,
but in a balance sheet, what is an intangible asset? Anything else? Absolutely right. Give him a big hand. Goodwill. Goodwill is an intangible asset. And I am only going to talk of, you are a brand in yourself. All of you are starting your corporate career. How many have worked in the industry before? Oh, so a lot of people have. So all learned people. So I don't have to tell a lot of things. But I can only tell you. And what I'm going to talk is based on two things. My 35 years of experience, which includes a lot of blunders I've done, which I've learned from my mistakes, a lot of some right things which I've done, and what I've observed, what works in industry, what doesn't work. And this is based on my observation across 35 years, across 1,000 people. So there's no empirical, I haven't got a patent for it, but I believe there's a lot of granularity in this entire thing. So when I say individual is a brand, how do you start your journey of building your brand yourself? That's a challenge in itself. So I will talk of certain key attributes. And I would like to illustrate the attributes with certain examples, and some of the examples may be from the corporate world, some beyond the corporate world also, just to see. Is that okay with you? Okay. I need more action. You know, I should be where I say yes, say no, or say yes, but I don't want like that. Huh? So can I be audience being more vocal? Yeah, I am 60 year old. You are not 60 year old, yeah. Huh? So you can be more vocal. So I said about intangible asset. You know, when you start your corporate world today, I remember when I started my corporate journey and after IIM Calcutta, the only reason I went to IIM Calcutta was that you got a job after passing out of IIM Calcutta. Because those days were the days of Satyajit Ray. Anybody heard of Satyajit Ray? Huh? He was a major filmmaker. And have you heard of Manoj Kumar? So he used to have those movies where the engineering graduate is there, he's very bright, but he doesn't get a job for 4 years, he becomes a laborer, which I can't imagine a scenario today. And that people used to empathize with those characters. I can't imagine a Satyajit Ray or Manoj Kumar type of movie being made. Because there are enough jobs, only challenge is, can I get better jobs? Or can I get something which is better fit, which is there? So, you know, the type of jobs initially were one types. Initially that time was a manufacturing industry. So you had manufacturing industry which had various departments, production, supply chain, quality, HR, IT, and marketing and sales. They could be in the private sector, it could be the public sector. But now the new type of jobs came in. The service industry wasn't there. So all these consultancies, investment bankings, you know, the service industry which is there. And the new type of new age industries. Like I am generally advisor to one group and I'm working with a lot of young people. Analytics, data mining, you know, we hear so many terms. So a lot of new streams emerged. And on top of it, the e-commerce companies, and on top of it, people who are starting their own ventures when they're passing out. So the choice available or the variety available or the boutique or the bouquet of flowers available is huge today, which was not there at our times. So not to that I am grudging you. I'm not grudging you, but I'm just saying the bouquet of issues, challenges, because that time was a controlled economy. How many follow history of business? I'm going to say history of India, history of business. Okay, who coined the term license, permit, quota, Raj? Because I am a national level quizzer, even so I generally try to quiz people also. Now this is part of not about general quizzing, this is about understanding industry. Navi, have you heard the term license, permit, quota, Raj? Yes. Who coined the term? I would expect at least somebody to answer that question here. Yeah? It's not that difficult question. It is a coin which was there by Chakravarti Rajagopalacharya. Have you heard his name? He used to oppose Nehru. So that time, because of the time, everything was restricted in the country. So you had to get a permit, quota, license, anything you have to do. Permissions were part of it. You haven't grown in the generation. Sir, you would have had some inkling of their generation. So I can empathize with the generation. So permit, quota, license, Raj. So everything was constrained. Government decided everything, what you could produce, what you could sell. Only one thing I like to say, you should get the perspective of business history clear in your mind in India. There is a saying, I'll do the first line, I have to complete it. Those who don't learn from history stand. What is the next term after it? A very famous English term. Those who don't learn from history stand. Huh? Am I asking irrelevant questions or am I asking very difficult questions? They can be two answers. Stand condemned by it. So that's an area which you have to work. So opportunities are galore. So I will just talk of 3-4 things which make, you know, one is your domain knowledge. So one is having a domain knowledge, the subjects which you teach. And if you're management students, one of the unique things in management is that all subjects of management, whether it's finance, whether it's HR, whether it's IT, they all combine together to make a good manager. Sometimes we believe that these concepts are not important. I'm going to marketing, doesn't matter. I'm going to analytics, this doesn't matter to me. HR doesn't matter to me, economics. But let me tell you, I've learned it the hard way. I'm like Rana Sangha. Rana Sangha, you heard the name Rana Sangha? What was unique about Rana Sangha? He never won a battle, yaar. He always lost to the... He was a brave man, but he went on. So he had a lot of wounds in his body. The only problem with him was that he doesn't learn from each wound. Kehte Rana Sangha ke... Everybody understands Hindi or anybody doesn't understand Hindi here? Anybody who doesn't understand a word of Hindi? Can you raise your hands? So, nobody? Anybody from South here? Which part of the South you are? Chennai, proper Chennai. And ma'am, you?
Kerala.
Which part of Kerala? Yeah, state I know.
Kottayam.
Where exactly? Kottayam? You said or what? Kottayam, which is there. Okay. So, when I was talking to Raal Sangha, you have a lot of wounds, hurt. Unke na bahut sare ghaav the. So, every ghaav, or you can say every wound itself, teaches you some things. The ability, I think 3-4 attributes are important in management stream. Ability to communicate. To me, this is, you'll be surprised, and don't take me wrong, I'm not here to shock you. This is one of the biggest, weakest link of management graduates in India who come into the corporate world. You say, what, yeah, this is like ability to communicate is the easiest thing. So when you're talking of ability to communicate, I'm talking of 3 aspects. Ability to listen, ability to assimilate, ability to communicate. When you move out in the corporate world, you have to communicate with people who are not like you. Generally, when we go to colleges, you know, generally we come from the same socio-economic background. People who get into IITs or good management institutions, they come from a certain middle class, upper middle class background. So your friends, your colleagues look fairly similar to you. But when you move out to the outside world, your customer is not like you, your vendor is not like you, your dealer is not like you, your colleague is not like you, your subordinate is not like you, your senior is not like you. So how do you communicate effectively? And one of the biggest weaknesses in communication is the ability to listen and assimilate. This is a big challenge across. So do you have the ability to listen and assimilate this thing? Ability to communicate. I'll tell you one simple thing just to explain the point. You are communicating to certain, say, a union people in the company who are working in the union or who are in the labor force. You're communicating to your colleagues. You're presenting to the board. You're presenting to your seniors. You're presenting to your dealers. You're talking in a meeting. Each of the things, the topic may be still be the same, but you have to fine tune your communication based on your target audience and your message. It's not easy. I'll give you one example. Can I give you an example? You know, when I was in Mahindra, I found, this is very interesting, I can quote it now. Mr. Anand Mahindra was very active on Twitter. So I was at Mahindra, there was a customer who wrote to Anand Mahindra on Twitter. He enclosed a letter written by the regional service manager of Mahindra to the customer, and he wrote in that, along with the letter, "Sir, where do you hire your people from? 8th class pass or 10th class fail?" Because that letter had 20 gaps, 20 logics wrong, spellings wrong, what not wrong. So Anand Mahindra called for me. So I said, what has happened? So I said, he said, nahi, sir. He says, sir, what are these people here? I don't know, you must change this guy. How can a person who's a regional service manager in Delhi, I said, he's my best regional service manager. So how can I change him? So he says, why? He says, what is he communicating? Even a student of 15th class is there. So he didn't know how to communicate with customers. So what I did was, all my regional sales and service manager, I told the lady who was HR, call them, we'll do a 2-day course on business communication. So you know, sales mein jo log hote hain, dada type hote hain. They bullied that lady. Kya hai, hum 20-15 saal corporate career mein ho gaye, you're going to teach us business communication. So they were bullying her, you know. So they, she said, she came crying ki, aapne bol to diya hai, they don't say anything to you, but whenever I call them up, they start laughing and they start bullying me. I said, let them come. So, you know, I gave them a simple example. What I did, and this was an example of introspection. There was a customer case, which was a very important customer problem case, which caused a lot of problems to the company because it was mishandled by the regional office, by the dealer. So I showed it to them, read it out. He said, yeah, we know of this case. So I said, this is the topic you can know of. He says, okay. I said, this is now the case. I handed a slip copy to each. I said, now the problem is, the MD is making a noise, the chairman, ki what has happened, why such cases are coming up. The media is making a noise. The consumer forum is making a noise. The ministry is making a noise. And the dealer or the regional office who's goofed up has it. Now you have to write 7 communications. One is to appease or to douse the flame of media, minister or the chairman, or tell the chairman what we are doing. Tell the dealer what blunder he's done. Tell the regional manager he's sleeping. So now you have to write 6 communications based on this letter. And I'm giving you 1.5 hours to write. And after writing, you paste your answers on the board. Can you believe it? Out of the 20 people who posted there, 6 replies, all the replies looked the same. So they could not understand who was their target customer. Now if you are writing to the consumer cell, you write in a different style. If you are writing to a dealer, you write in a different style. Because the message and the impact you want is different. So this was then they realized that they cannot communicate. Everybody knows how to write letters. Then that 2-day seminar went off very well. And people said we got it extended for half a day. So people 15 years in the career who had fairly reasonable movement in the career world, both in sales and after sales, and who were customer facing, could not communicate effectively. This is one of the weakest links. I'm not saying, how many are very good at it? Can you raise your hands? Because I'll give a test to them then. Kaun hai bhai? Nahi, simple test I'll give, not a difficult test here. Sab ghabra gaye. Kaun bhala mein? Kaun haath daale? Pata nahi kya puchne wale. The point is, try to put an example and try to use this yourself and see how difficult it is or how difficult it is to communicate. But communication is not the problem. The ability to communicate to the right person, this is one of the weak areas. Because when you are going up in the organizations, you get 5 minutes, 10 minutes and you get only 8 slides. In India, we have this concept of 50 slides, bana do, data dikha do, linkage kar do. Nobody has time for that. That shows weakness and arrogance to me. जिसको क्लैरिटी है उसको 10 स्लाइड में अपना कंटेंट कर सकता है, कैन कम्युनिकेट. एंड जिसको नहीं क्लैरिटी है, उसके एनेक्शर्स भी होंगे, उसके अटैचमेंट्स भी होंगे, उसके लिंक्स भी होंगे, बिकॉज दे आर नॉट वेरी क्लियर. सो प्लीज लर्न दिस आर्ट. एंड स्पेशली मैनेजमेंट ग्रेजुएट्स, इंजीनियरिंग ग्रेजुएट्स, आई वुड स्टिल गिव देम सम लीवे, बट मैनेजमेंट ग्रेजुएट्स, इफ प्रोफेसर बरुआ अलाउज मी आफ्टर आई कम बैक 2 मंथ्स एंड होल्ड अ स्पेशल क्लास ऑन बिजनेस कम्युनिकेशन एंड आई रेज द बार. But students are not happy with it, na? Should I come after 2 months?
Yes, sir.
मैंने बोला यार क्या यार बला अच्छे बैठे बैठे हुए हैं. Why are you troubling us? The ability to listen. You know, one of the problems that I learned from Japanese very good. They are very good listeners. हमारे Indians we have presupposed our minds. I'll give a very interesting example. I was in Maruti Suzuki. So one junior Japanese had joined at a senior level in Maruti because Japanese था तो he was put a. So there was one person in our batch, one person who was my colleague, tha, slightly junior to me. He was happy, he would comment on everything. Kuch log hote hain, har cheez pe comment hota hai unka, chahe pata ho na pata ho. So we were coming down the lift from 16th floor to the ground floor. So har floor pe lift ruk rahi thi. So I was in the lift, he was in the lift, and that Japanese was in the lift, and 3-4 more people in the lift. And wo shuru ho gaya apne style mein. Ye Japani aa jate hain, inko pata tha, hota nahi, DJ bana dete hain, hum lage hue hain, IM se aaye hain, ye wo. Shuru hota gaya, bolta gaya, commentary uski running commentary thi. जैसे ही लिफ्ट पहुंची ग्राउंड फ्लोर में, ही सेड टकरे कसान प्लीज यू कैन स्टेप आउट. कहते नहीं सुकुमार सान, आप पहले जाइए, मैं आपके बाद जाऊंगा. इसको शौक लग गया. कहता आपको हिंदी आता है, यू नो हिंदी? मैंने यहां आने से पहले 6 महीने का हिंदी में अध्ययन किया टोक्यो विश्वविद्यालय में. सुकुमार डिडंट कम टू ऑफिस फॉर 4 डेज. फोन, अरे यार कुछ बोला तो नहीं उसने? मैंने बोला सुकुमार तेरे को अपनी रनिंग कमेंट्री की क्या जरूरत थी? रनिंग कमेंट्री दिए जा रहा है ऊपर से नीचे तक, किस लिए जरूरत है तेरे को? वो बैठा हुआ है. सो यू आर जंपिंग टू कंक्लूजंस, यू आर जंपिंग टू कंक्लूजंस बिकॉज यू बिलीव दैट जापानीज डज नो नी हिंदी एंड आई कैन कीप लंबास्टिंग हिम, क्रिटिसाइजिंग हिम, पुलिंग हिज लेग इन हिंदी एंड ही वुड नो. एंड दैट गाय अंडरस्टूड एवरीथिंग. द ओनली प्रॉब्लम विद जापानीज इज इवन इफ दे एंग्री दे डोंट शो ऑन देयर फेस. तो अभी कभी नहीं पता लगा दैट जापानीज अंडरस्टूड इट बट ही डिडंट शो, ही वाज अ नाइस गाय. अदर कोई और होता उसका, उसके 3 दिन बाद मैंने बोला आ जा यार तू, आ जा ऑफिस. कहता नहीं नहीं पता कर लो यार, कोई चक्कर तो नहीं है. सो ही डिडंट कम टू ऑफिस फॉर 3 डेज. सो आई होप that is called jumping to conclusions, you know, poor listening ability. So interacting, how do you interact? Because you know, when you have dealers or distributors or anybody in marketing you deal with, you have a different profile of people. You have to understand the person and then interact and relate with him. Now these are skills. You know, one thing which I'll just like to add to you, I've been 35 years in the corporate world. So we had a reunion of our batch after 35 years, just 5 months back. एंड भाई जिसने जो कुछ पहुंचना था 20 साल में पहुंच जाएगा, अच्छा बुरा जैसा भी है. सो आई फाउंड पीपल्स हुज सोशल स्किल्स और ईक्यू वाज बेटर, दोज आर द पर्सन्स हु हैव रिज़न बेस्ट. एंड देयर आर सम पीपल हु आर वेरी ब्राइट, वेरी इंटेलिजेंट, बट वर से यूनिडायमेंशनल और मे बी लोनर्स और मे नॉट हैव दिस थिंग, दे कुड नॉट राइज. सो Domain knowledge is one thing. I'm not trying to undermine the importance of domain knowledge. But what I'm saying is this social skill is important. Do you agree or no?
Yes, sir.
What is the conscious effort you are making to improve on this? You know, we were trained for television interviews because we had to attend the TV, you know, because we were a listed company, so they were company spokesman, I was one of them. And we got a lady, and you don't heard the name, she was a very famous lady in television before, Sabira Merchant, to train us. Anybody heard of Sabira Merchant? Yeah, aapke bahut pehle ki baat hai. She used to be in television in the 60s and 70s. So she grilled us right, left and center. So usne to hamare jo mera boss tha usko to itni usne dhajiya udai ki wo bechara kehta tumhe kisne bana diya CEO? Hain tum kya karoge communicate? Wo bechara lunch ke baad aaya hi nahi, ghar chala gaya. Wo kehta main family mein hai. So what I am saying is she made us realize that we are not fit for communication. We thought that humne main soch raha maine debating ki hai ye ki hai, but she found 20 gaps in my communication. So I'm saying is communication, the power of communication, the power to influence will only increase as you go up. And you have to be good listeners, good assimilators, and good ability to communicate written and verbal. And a lot of people think nahi yaar vocabulary se bada farak padta hai, meri vocabulary hai nahi, main web aur dictionary padh lu, main hazar words aur seekh lu. Let me tell you, to communicate effectively you only need 2000 words in English, which everybody has in 8th class. So vocabulary is not the criteria. So I'm talking a very basic thing, bole kya farak padta hai, but this is not focused so much. You have a program, I think, in business communication. Can you have me as a Viva instructor to check up, dear everybody? The students don't want me, yaar. वो बोले अच्छे खासे पास हो रहे हैं, यूनिवर्सिटी आके पंगा करेगा, हैं? You don't want me to say. Then is ability to relate. What is MAS? MAS is abbreviation MAS. Well, this I would expect you to know. This is a term coined by me. It's called Mutual Admiration Society. You relate with people who are like you. You make friends because aapke hometown se hain ya unki same habits hain ya same hai. So you ultimately end up Mutual Admiration Society is main aapki tareef karu, aap lajawab hai, aap bhi lajawab hai. So you keep on praising each other. One of the problems is we try to do Mutual Admiration Society. So we identify certain people. They may be known to us. Who we want to be close to, and we only communicate. Projects bhi honge, college mein bhi honge. My one humble submission I'm making, when you have projects given to students, who decides that who will be the members of the project group? Huh? Nee, who decides? I don't want to give the power to the students to decide. This is done by a lot of US universities. They do random number generation. They decide who will be your project partner, it's by random draw. Because you get into a comfort zone. Ek mein analytic mein strong hai, ek presentation mein strong hai, ek samosa peena jane ka hesab kitab theek rakhta hai. So you know, you combine the group with all the skills together and they do all projects together. Please have, and it's by design, I would say. So I should come by from their own mind, but do not have design in projects. People should not be allowed to choose who will be their partners in the project. Is it, do you agree with me or no? Aapko mushkil wala kaam hai. And then the other part. Abhi to kuch hua nahi hai, abhi to kehte hai na raat baki hai. In the project presentation, you will decide, suppose four people are part of the project, who will speak and what part he will speak. And the question the professor will ask, you will decide who will answer the question in the group. Generally hota hai na, group mein ek hota hai, jisne bada thorough kiya hota hai, baki to khade hote hai ki, they have to be in the right group, intelligent person, I'll be with them. Because, you know, I learned the hard way because I've done. Kehte na ki, why did in Shole film Sanjeev Kumar get Amitabh Bachchan and criminals to fight Gabbar Singh? Because they knew how a criminal works, so I also understand like that. So the point is, the person who's not done the project well himself or herself, uske face se dikh jayega. Body language, face, expression. So the weakest link of the chain in a team, when you go in management, na, the weakest link of the chain is the strength of the chain. So group project not decided, this is part of it. Another thing which I'm coming to, Mutual Admiration Society, diverse. Because you know, when you have different project groups, I went to course in Kellogg's, I learned it the other day. We had 40 people from India and there were 11 projects given to us 2 weeks. Every project there was, I was in a project group with every person. Some were African, some were Indian, some were there, but you know, you learned. There were some Chinese who we couldn't communicate, but they had to be part of a project. So ability. The other challenge is move out of comfort zone. Comfort zone, can anyone tell me what is comfort zone? Please raise your hand and answer.
Play by
your strengths. Anybody else?
Where people don't want to step ahead from that step.
So you know, the best time to move out of comfort zone is because you have certain strengths. Everybody has his or her strengths. And sometimes those strengths take you far away. You should have those strengths, you should reinforce. But sometimes there are certain weaknesses or certain gaps which don't surface so easily. Moment they start surfacing, they become your Achilles heel. Anybody can tell me what is Achilles heel? It's like that, you know, there's a Greek mythology mein hai ki you couldn't kill the person anywhere, but heel mein ek jagah thi, you hit there and that's the Achilles heel, the person will get finished. So they become your Achilles heel. So one is that you learn the hard way. You're pushed. So you know, marta kya na karta. The other is, how do you proactively move out of comfort zone? And I'm going to tell a story. I was in Mahindra that time and we had a great escape. Somebody's from Mahindra here, na? You are in Mahindra, there's a great escape you heard of, na? So this is to done on sand dunes. We used to get some high profile people to see that how Mahindra vehicles perform on terrains and this thing. अभी तक चॉकलेट का किसी ने आंसर दिया नहीं है आ गई चॉकलेट्स अगर आप नहीं जवाब दोगे तो ये चॉकलेट मैं ही ले जाऊंगा मैं ही खाऊंगा बट नॉट सूटेबल फॉर मी बिकॉज सो देयर वेरी हाई प्रोफाइल पीपल कॉल्ड सो आई वाज टोल्ड टू कंपनी वन ऑफ द हाई प्रोफाइल पर्सन फ्रॉम सी एनीबॉडी बिलोंग्स टू राजस्थान हियर कहां को बिलोंग करते हैं आप कोटा और कहां से है बीकानेर से हाँ और अलवर से है चूरू कितना दूर है बीकानेर से हाँ क्या बोला आई डिडंट हियर 500 किलोमीटर्स अलवर से कितना दूर है अलवर वाले कहाँ है हाँ कितना दूर है चूरू 300 और कोई बोल सकता है जयपुर से कितना दूर है चूरू 100s में आ रहे हैं यूनिट ऑफ करेंसी कम नहीं हो रही है 200 300 500 आई एम श्योर किलोमीटर्स व्हेन यू मेजर माउंटेन तो माउंट एवरेस्ट इज मेजर्ड बाय 29,000 टू फीट द टू फीट इज नॉट लेफ्ट एनीवे द पॉइंट वाज आई वाज टू कंपनी द बॉश का चेयरमैन वाज फॉर 10 इयर्स टू फ्रॉम चूरू टू दिल्ली एंड आई वाज टू कंपनी हिम बिकॉज ही वाज वेरी सीनियर पर्सन ही वाज टू कैच अ फ्लाइट फ्रॉम दिल्ली एंड द व्हीकल वाज अलॉटेड समहाउ देयर वाज अ कंफ्यूजन एंड दिस आई लर्नड द रॉन्ग वे दैट Always check up before things. Don't jump to conclusions or don't presume things. मैंने check नहीं की मैंने administration में गाड़ी arrange करेंगे. Something happened with that person had a video call telecall with some abroad. So सब गाड़ियाँ चली गई एंड में जो गाड़ी बची थी हमारे लिए बची थी बलेरो नॉन ए सी 44 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड में आई वॉज टू गेट हिम फ्रॉम चूरू टू डेली इन अ बलेरो नॉन ए सी नॉन पावर स्टीयरिंग वो उसने सूट पहना हुआ पसीना आ रहा था उसने कोट खोल दिया तो ही वॉज लुकिंग लाइक हियर एंड देयर तो मैंने कहा मेरी तो नौकरी गई ही विल कॉल अप यार क्या मजाक बना रखा है कि आई मीन दैट थिंग आई एम नॉट एक्सपेक्टिंग अ सुपर लग्जरी कार बट अ नॉन एसी व्हीकल 44 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड एंड आई सेड सॉरी आई टोल्ड हिम मिस्टर विश्वनाथ आई एम वेरी सॉरी तो विश्वनाथ सेड नो आई एम एंजॉइंग इट तो मैंने कहा ही इज बीइंग सार्कास्टिक हाउ कैन यू बी एंजॉइंग इट यार मेरे पसीने निकल रहे हैं मेरे तो दो तरीके से पसीने निकल रहे थे एक गर्मी से और एक डर से सो आई सेड हाउ आर यू एंजॉइंग इट I mean, very sarcastic a bit. How can he be enjoying in a tooty booty gaadi, thak thak kar rahi hai, isme AC bhi nahi chalta hai. So he said, and he said, you know, he told me a story. Whenever people ask me a question, I probe them further. That's my habit, good or bad. So he said, he was a very bright person and he did his IITC engineering and MBA from Ahmedabad and got into levers. So Hindustan lever mein, they have a concept of, which a lot of companies have. Especially in marketing and sales, that you have a upcountry rural posting for 6 months, which makes you tougher or makes you understand what the ground realities are. So generally what people used to do is, suppose somebody belongs to Tamil Nadu, he'll take to Dindigul, somebody belongs to Rajasthan, he will do it somewhere near Sikar. You know, people take their trainings in the state which they are. So his boss said, he was from Tamil Nadu, ki aapko Dindigul karun, Polachi karun, yahan karun. He says, no, I want my 6 month internship in an area where I've never been. which is the toughest district, which is the most, I've never heard of it, and which is the toughest place to live, survive, and to do business. I want my training there. So, kehta, my boss told me, yaar, who was my coordinator? Kehta, don't joke. We can send you, then you will then regret it. He said, no, I want it. He said, by broad. So he says, his boss fixed him a place called ETA, E-T-A-H. Wo UP se hai yahan par? UP sare honge. ETA ka hai koi? You have to be careful speaking, you know, ETA. Main kuch ETA ka kuch bolne wala hoon, so I have to be careful, koi ETA ka to nahi hai yahan par. Who's from ETA? Huh? Achha, where is ETA located? Chaliye. So many people from UP. Kahan kahan se hai UP se aap log? Yeah. You are from? Huh? Gorakhpur, to bahut dur hai ETA se. Aur koi aas paas hai ETA se? हाँ वाराणसी भी बहुत दूर है कानपुर ठीक है पर फिर भी दूर है और कोई जगह नहीं आसपास गाजियाबाद तो दिल्ली में हो गए चलो वो भी है तो एनीबडी फ्रॉम आगरा आगरा मथुरा सो इफ यू गो द क्लोजेस्ट बिग टाउन टू एटा इज आगरा सो अब एटा से कोई नहीं है ना यू नो वंस इट हैपेंड यू नो आई वाज गिविंग अ लेक्चर आई वाज टेलिंग दैट विच एग्जांपल एंड दिस वाज 4 मंथ्स बैक आई सेड Talent is not everything. Hard work, commitment, focus is. Look at Kamli, look at Sachin. What Kamli, we used to get drunk, used to dance. I asked somebody, Kamli, I am his nephew. So, I didn't know where to look at. Yaar. So you have to be careful when you ask questions. In the audience, somebody may be there. So ETA is a district in the 70s. Aaj bhi aisa hi hai. One of the most backward criminal. Har koi katta leke chalta hai. Gali se niche baat nahi karta. Goli daagta hai. Gali aur hai. And he was posted hardcore. Tabilian was posted for 6 months there. मुझे तो समझ नहीं आया मैं क्या कर रहा हूँ लैंग्वेज मुझे समझ नहीं आया हिंदी भी नहीं आती गालियों में बात होती थी हर चीज़ पे बंदूक फायर करते थे स्काई में और वो प्रेम कथा जो अक्षय कुमार मूवी है यू टू गो टू द फील्ड्स देयर इज नो होटल देयर सो ही सेज आई लॉस्ट 9 kg वेट इन 2 मंथ्स एंड आई स्टार्टेड थिंकिंग माई बॉस कि मैंने कुछ गलती तो नहीं की तो ही सेज बट आई सेड नाउ आई हैव कम इट कांट बी चेंज्ड ही सेज आफ्टर 2 मंथ्स आई स्टार्टेड एडजस्टिंग टू ETA And in the last 3 months, I even developed a liking for their food, their language, their style. And if I became the youngest marketing director of Levers, he became at age 43, it was because of my tough training in ETA. Now, is it something credible? So give Mr. Srinathan a big hand. I can tell him. So, difference is, I also have an example like this, but I was pushed. See, if you're pushed to something, then you are not moved out of comfort zone. You have been pushed out of comfort zone. But here was a person who proactively moved out of comfort zone. How many of you, raise your hands and give me examples, who proactively move out of comfort zone? They know this is important. Abhi zarurat nahi hai. You can get away with it. But you have proactively moved out of comfort zone. It may be in a personal life or professional life. Anybody? Aisa to nahi hoga. Haan, boliye. Kis tarah se aap move out kiye comfort zone se bahar? जिम तो यार इतना कंफर्ट जोन से बाहर नहीं होता हम कोई जिम जा रहा है कंफर्ट जोन इज लाइक इज टोटली अगेंस्ट योर स्टाइल एंड इट हैज लॉट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स सो कंफर्ट जोन इज आई एम रेजिंग द बार अच्छा सो दैट यू मूव आवर कंफर्ट जोन ओके गुड एनीबडी एल्स मैम
ओके
गुड Okay, please give her a big hand. Not an easy task. But were you forced by somebody or took a conscious call? It's your inner voice. So, you know, if you move out of comfort zone, you will always progress. Hamare kai log hote hain postings lete hain, nahi saal mere hometown mein posting kar do, nearby where my friends are. People who and more geographies, who take more risks at a younger age, they do better in career. This is one thing I've seen. People who move out of comfort zones do better. Because they develop faculties, they develop these things which they wouldn't have developed in the long run. And whatever unique points you develop at a younger age, it's easier. So if somebody asked me, sir, are you making a presentation? So I said, no, I don't like making presentations. But you know what the reality is? I was in comfort zone. For last 15 years, I had executive assistant. So I don't know how to make a presentation, Excel file. So I don't make presentation. So that's the real answer. The odd answer I will give you in a profession, no, I like talking to people, I don't like the slides to do. But the real is that thing. So I never, mujhe pata hai, kabhi ek phase aayega, mujhe apne presentation banane padenge. Har time to mere executive assistant nahi rahega mere saath, koi MBA tha, come aaya bhai, make the slide, show me again. So I am used to that culture 15 years. So that is, you know, when you get to comfort zone, then you suffer somewhere. So how do your ability to move out of comfort zone? Building relationships. When I talk about projects, is how do you build relationships with people who are not like you and whom you don't like as such? Some people aise to baat karni nahi maine. There is some reason, you know, there is a chemistry working here, isko chhodo, isse nahi baat karni. You have to, in life, in career, you have to relate to people who are not like you. And sometimes you have to work with people whom you don't on a personal level even like. You have to build up that ability. So when you are in college, that's the best time. Try to talk to people. I don't know here, but generally I've seen when people come now for lectures, even the three friends come together, they sit together only. You know, when I used to address some people in, really very interesting thing, you know, I used to address a GT batch in Mahindra. So 200 people joined the GT. So I says, who are from Punjab? 9 people raised their hands. All will be sitting together after 1 month. Who are from Gujarat? All 6. So I said, these are not MPs being taken away by Kumaraswamy or somebody, you know, to one thing. So this is like comfort zone. You are moving in your own herd mentality. So ability to relate is going to be a very, very important thing. Then I'm coming to slightly harder skills. So you will say soft skills, domain knowledge. Those of you who are in management, how many were not non-management streams? Unko hath khada kare, because then I will, who are not part of MBA. Aur dekhiye, wo bhi comfort zone mein, panch ek saath hi baithe hain. Is it by coincidence? By the law of probability. So again, raise the hands, people who are non-management students. Non-management. Chemistry. Nahi, main non-management keh raha hu. Kahan khade kar do yaar, pura nahi pura karo. Ab ye kuch probability nahi lagti ki 7 people of non-management or 10 sitting together. It can't be by law of probabilities. Can be by law of probability. So they move differently. And that is the assumption I'm making. Because by do any mathematical exercise, it cannot be possible. That only 10% are non-management students here and out of them 80% are sitting together. By law probability, it will not work. Will it work? So this is, you know, and it can be unconscious even. It can be unconscious. It's not the conscious. So how do you move out of that comfort zone? Other is domain knowledge. If you are in management, and if you are in any subject, forget management engineering, you better know your basics of your subject. You will learn at your own cost. I learned it at my own cost. You know, I thought that I was to be a marketing person, so I did some finance courses, but okay, I knew how to score marks, but that's one thing. 20 years later, when there was some problem in dealers' profitability, our head of, our MD called me and said, Arun, you have to conduct sessions yourself to teach dealer how to enhance their profitability. Now, if you have to enhance somebody's profitability, you have to understand not only the business, you have to understand financial fundamentals. And my fundamentals were not very clear. I mean, it was not clear that I could guide somebody. Can you believe it? At the age of 50, I went back to read finance books. I had my friend who was CA, used to go from some classes or crash courses. So reality caught up with me. There are various parts of the management thing which you think is not your area. As you go up, you are not a specialist only. Your domain knowledge has to everything. Do you incorporate all things? So a lot of people say, yeah, management itne subject padhate hai, sab bekar hai. Main bhi ye sochta tha us samay. Kya yaar, ye kya padha rahe hai? Sociology, psychology, economics, ye, wo. But there's a method to that madness. And those who ignore the fundamentals learn at their own cost. Management students have to be aware not only their domain knowledge, but the external domain knowledge which is impacting their basic domain knowledge. So let me say, in management, who's doing finance? How many doing marketing? Okay. And how many doing HR? Very few people. How many are doing, say, information technology or data, what do you call it? Data science. So, you know, what are the things would be, please learn how the external world is impacting your domain knowledge. If suppose electric vehicles was one part of the automobile is there. Can you believe it? I didn't focus too much on engineering fundamentals. Nowadays, I am advisor to a lot of consultancies. I realize my limitation is my engineering knowledge. Today, I attend every seminar, engineering seminar in Delhi as a student. Okay, sir, you are aage baithi, aap aage baithi. Main nahi, main piche baitha hu, because purani kartute hain. My past, because now I have to be advisor to a KPMG or a McKinsey. So I can't say that I haven't done that. I mean, MD of a company, so my marketing knowledge is okay. My finance knowledge is now okay. But if my technical knowledge is not okay, I have a problem. So even at the age of 60, I'm realizing my limitations which are going up, and I have to work extra hard on it. And let me tell you, so are you ready to invest on fundamentals beginning? There's no scope for fundamentals. So can we get one student on finance, one from marketing here on the stage? One from finance, one from marketing, one from HR. Aiyah. I'll pick up. क्या भाई ऐसा पूछ ले मैं कोई I'm not leaning to the gallows यार फांसी नहीं हो जाएगी किसी को हाँ इधर ऊपर आ जाओ स्टेज पे नीचे नहीं आप शक्ल नहीं दिखेगी सब ऊपर आइए you are in the limelight भाई first of all give them back add them the guts to come up so you are from which stream and you are from नहीं एक और चाहिए था marketing में से एक वापस चला जाए I need somebody from
चलो मैं
एचआर में करेंगे ओके सो यू आर फाइनेंस सो कैन वी जज यू ऑन बेसिक थिंग्स ऑन फाइनेंस एक्सप्लेन टू द स्टूडेंट्स ऑल दीज करेंसीज डिवेल्यूशन विच इज हैपनिंग इन टर्की ग्रीस हाउ डज इट इंपैक्ट द इंडियन इकोनॉमी इधर आइए हाउ डज A problem in Turkey and Greece impacts India. They have a devaluation of their currency. So India is very far from, we don't do much business with Turkey, we don't do business with Greece. And this is coming every day in the paper. So what I'm going to ask questions are which are every day. I'm not going to ask some rocket science questions.
One thing that impacts directly to India is the goods that India is exporting to this countries. So
but India is not exporting much to Turkey and to Greece, so that's out. So I'll keep questioning you again and again. Chalo. Can anybody answer it? Yeah. Huh? Do you agree with his answer? I'm not the judge. His answer is better than yours. You have to admit that. But do you agree? Okay, thanks. Anyway, you also tried good. Marketing kaun hai? Are you deciding who's marketing now? There is one acronym which is being discussed everywhere in marketing. These are called FAGS. FAAGS. It is in every newspaper today, FAGS, FAA, UNO, United Nations Organizations, UNICEF, FAGS. What does it mean and what is the relevance of it? First of all, what does the abbreviation mean and what is the relevance of it? And this is a question which I would expect 90% people to know. FAAGS, FAGS. This is a term, just a selfie term, this term has become 2 years ago, which is a understood term now in the business terminology of international. अगर आप नहीं करेंगे तो audience को pass करेंगे. लोग कब answer कर रहे हैं तो मैं chocolate खाना शुरू कर रहा हूँ. हाँ जी. Anybody in the stage would like to answer fags? हाँ. हाँ and take it to the relevance yeah. Absolutely, give her a big hand. So FAGS is being discussed because these are disrupting the economy of the world, these companies. The way business is done. And they are all dominating. So that's why you have antitrust. The FAGS, Facebook, Amazon, Apple and Google. Huh? I'm sorry. So, now this is something, how many knew it, hand to the heart, tell me, she answered it. कितना को पता था प्लीज द थिंग हाउ मेनी न्यू दिस आई वुड एक्सपेक्ट 80% पीपल टू नो दिस बिकॉज दिस इज बीइंग डिस्कस्ड सो व्हाट आई एम सेइंग इज यू हैव टू बी मोर इन टच विद द रियलिटी व्हाट्स हैपनिंग सो नॉट ओनली डू अ लॉट ऑफ रीडिंग do a lot of understanding, because all these things will impact you. Haan ji, next area kaun tha? HR. We have called HR, maybe we call of Generation Z. We used to call of, there are three types of generations called. What is Generation Z? What does it mean? When HR we call Generation Z.
I'm not aware from the HR perspective, but.
Nahin, wohi hoga jo perspective. Haan. So what does it mean?
From a demographic perspective, it's an age cohort.
Huh? Okay, I'll ask another simple thing. BINK is discussed. Marketing people are targeting this segment very strongly. DINK. How many are doing marketing? अब कोई marketing नहीं कर रहा अब लग रहा है. End में पता लगा management ही नहीं कर रहे हम. Dink. This is the biggest. Yeah, बोलो. Absolutely. Give him a big hand. Give him at least a chocolate. So you know, they have the maximum money. Husband, wife, working, no kids. So they say attack that segment. Double income, no kids. Now these are acronyms. These are things which are being discussed. If you are reading some what's happening, they are child's play. If you're not reading, they are like double Dutch and double German. Depends on what you are. How many knew this? What you answered, Dink? 1, 2. So please start. Please give them a big hand. So, I'm trying to open your, see, the idea is not that if you don't know Dinks or this thing, but I'm trying to understand how much you understand what is happening. How does a private equity firm work? How is it different from the angel investors? There are so many things there, and they are not taught in management books. They may be taught, but you have to take an active interest of this thing. New financial terms, social cost benefit analysis, a new way of looking at finance, which is not only looks at return on investment, it looks at what is the benefit to society on finance. So if any subject you're doing, please extend your boundary of domain of knowledge. मैं कुछ ज़्यादा पूछ रहा हूँ, कुछ ज़्यादा मांग रहा हूँ, मेरा तो कुछ नहीं जाता, आप करो ना करो, हैं? I'm asking, but so you see, वो कहते हैं आवाज़ दिल से आनी चाहिए, आवाज़ कोई फोर्स नहीं कर सकता कि मैं आपको फोर्स करूँ, आप ये करो, वो करो, वो नहीं हो सकता. जब तक दिल से आवाज़ नहीं आएगी, नहीं होगा. I'll give you one example. You know, people who move out of comfort zone and who have that drive. This is one very interesting example which I can give you, that how people who have that ability is nothing to do with what field they are in. When I was in Nissan, so we identified that Sakshi Malik was doing well in the wrestling. So we said, why not take her as a brand, because Datsun was a people's brand. So we met the person who was manager. That time she had not won the bronze medal, and we hired her for 10 lakh rupees for a 6-month contract. वो मेरा अच्छा एक तरह जुआ था कि उसके बाद उसका रेट 50 लाख हो गया और 10 लाख में हमने कर लिया था, बिकॉज ही हैड वन अ मेडल दैट टाइम. सो आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू इंसिडेंट अबाउट साक्षी मलिक. सो वी हैड कम फॉर कॉल्ड हर फॉर अ लॉन्च ऑफ अपग्रेड मॉडल इन दिल्ली इन होटल, एंड द होल आइडिया देर वॉज दैट देर वॉज अ कार विच वॉज टू कम फ्रॉम बिहाइंड द स्क्रीन, स्टेज था, एंड चल के बीच में आएगी, एंड आई एंड साक्षी मलिक वॉन्ट टू सिट, नॉट दैट आई वॉन्ट टू सिट विद साक्षी मलिक, बट दैट वॉज अ प्रोटोकॉल की एंड आई विल ड्राइव एंड देन शील गेट आउट द कार. साक्षी मलिक कहती है, आई एम द ब्रांड एम्बेसडर, आई शुड बी ड्राइविंग, वाई शुड ही बी ड्राइविंग. तो सबने उस हर, बिकॉज द स्टेज वॉज सच, इतना टाइट लाइटिंग, ये मतलब यू नीड टू मैनेवर द कार, इट्स नॉट ईजी, एंड आई हैव ऑल्सो प्रैक्टिस इट. तो मैंने साक्षी से पूछा, मैं साक्षी व्हेन डू लर्न कार ड्राइविंग, ये 4-5 महीने हो गए सीखे हुए, जब से मैं आई हूँ ओलंपिक से. मैंने बोला 4 महीने ओलंपिक से और स्टेज पर गाड़ी गई गिरा दी, मतलब स्टेज के बाहर ही जमीन पर गिरा दी. सो आई डिस्करेज हर, नो नो, इफ आई एम द ब्रांड एम्बेसडर भाई मैं प्रैक्टिस कर लूँगी. Can you believe it? She had come at 10. For 1.5 hours, she practiced 20 times. And she drove that car at 11:30 on the stage in the exact manner. Now that is her moving out of comfort zone. Nothing to do with the wrestling. Wrestling and car driving is now no relationship. And the first time she's driven the car is after coming to the Olympics. So, you know, these people who achieve something, they have something X factor in them, which is a more personal factor, which has nothing to do with the actual sport. Why should she take the risk? उसको उतना ही पैसा मिल रहा है, कहाँ पंगे में पड़े, मेरे को पड़े मैं भी नहीं ड्राइव करूँगा, कहाँ चक्कर, बिकॉज दे आर लाइटिंग, दे आर स्टेज, यू टू ब्रिंग इट दिस वे, यू टू पार्क इट दिस वे, इट्स नॉट ईजी. आई मीन इन अ स्मॉल स्टेज टू मैनेवर अ कार एंड विद लाइटिंग एंड द म्यूजिक, सो यू नो एंड यू हैव द ग्रैंड एंट्री ऑफ द कार. शी डिड इट, She said, I can do it and I will practice and I will do it. Now that is also moving out of comfort zone, or you have the ability to take risks with effort. Would you do it? I would do it. But Sakshi Malik did it. So that's why I admire, you know, these people have something. I've seen people who achieve. And another example, can I give another example? This is more relatable, Rahul Dravid. See, one thing, advantage in the auto industry is you meet a lot of people. So once there was a big function being planned by some oil company, our MD was called, he had some busy meeting, director, he had to go to Japan. So mera aa gaya ki I will be with Rahul Dravid on stage. And we'll have exclusive lunch with Rahul Dravid, and he was the Indian cricket captain that time. So two things I noted about Rahul Dravid, which I can never forget. First is a very simple thing. The function was at 2:30 and we were having lunch. Jaise baithe hue, main tha, Rahul tha, koi aur unka Castrol ka MD tha. And I was not very senior, I was GM tha. And Rahul was India's cricket captain, so I mean, kahan Raja Bhoj, kahan Gangu Teli, I mean, there was not a comparison. So main khana kha raha tha, to khate khate mere dal mere yahan lag gayi. What he did, he took a napkin and apne aap usne meri dal yahan se yun ki. Look at that thoughtfulness factor. नहीं तो खाता रहे इसके दाल लगते रहे फेस पे दूसरा बता ऐसा आपके देखिए दाल लगी दैट वुड बी अनदर थिंग ही पिक्ड अप अ नैपकिन एंड डिड इट बट दैट्स नॉट द इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट सो आफ्टर लंच वी वर डिस्कसिंग अदर थिंग्स सो आई आस्क्ड राहुल द्रविड़ वन क्वेश्चन सो आई सेड राहुल टेल मी वन थिंग यू हैव बीन क्रिकेटर थ्रू आउट एंड दैट दोज डेज T20 वॉज नॉट देयर हाउ इज दैट That you had a brilliant academic record. He had, suppose, a very brilliant academic record in school, college. Most of the cricketers can't pass school, whether it's a Kapil Dev or whether it's a Sachin. How did you get? So he told me a story which I can never forget, and that to me is the role model story. He didn't tell. He says, "I said, tell me, how could you top him?" He said, "I said you were playing under 16, under 18. Because I had followed him, I had done some lot of study on him before I met him that day." So he said one thing. He says, "When I was in my 10th class, I was very good in studies. My father was an engineer." So one day I came back from coaching and one day I went for my coaching, cricket coaching, and the coach said ki your father ne phone kiya hai, your father has called up, he doesn't want you to continue cricket at all. So he says he's removed your name from the coaching. So he says I was shaken up. Mera passion cricket hai and my father has removed him without telling me. So he said I couldn't fight with the father, I was very obedient son, so I went and cried ki why have you removed from the cricket coaching. So his father said, yeah, he used to get 85-90% marks, the moment you're getting into active cricket, your marks have started going down, you're back to 60-65, and cricket is a career you don't know. So it's better to give up cricket. I've seen enough players who are clerks, who became players, played one test match. So I don't want you to risk your life. And you're a bright student. So he says, I told my father, what do you want me to do? I want to continue cricket. He says, as long as you keep getting your 85% marks, which you used to get, I have no problem, you can continue cricket. So he says, I used to go for a Ranji match under 18 to Tumkur, to Delhi, train me log, gaane ga rahe. मैं फिजिक्स न्यूमेरिकल सॉल्व कर रहा हूँ मेरी बैटिंग 3 डाउन है मैं केमिस्ट्री के कुछ पीरियोडिक टेबल कर रहा हूँ टू कीप हिज क्रिकेट अलाइव ही मेड एन एक्स्ट्रा एफर्ट टू गेट 85% मार्क्स इन स्कूल दैट शोज ग्रेट डिटर्मिनेशन दैट इज व्हाई इज कॉल्ड द वॉल गिव राहुल अ बिग हैंड ऑफ दैट सो दीज आर पीपल यू नो व्हिच आई हैव मेट लाइक साक्षी मलिक आई टोल्ड यू Who are something, they haven't risen because of they had contacts or they had this thing, something that X factor. And X factor is about intensity, involvement, never say die spirit and never shirking a challenge. So that's a part of it. So moving out of comfort zone, you talked enough. Managing complexity. Ek problem, how much is the work pressure in the management students here? Nahin, pressure kitna hai ki? So does it makes them in the pressure or no pressure? हाँ भाई बहुत pressure है कि नहीं है हाँ है कि नहीं यार सीधा बोलो यार है नहीं है बहुत ज़्यादा है कि ज़्यादा है You know that pressure should be such you know that you should have you know there's an old Gurudat movie dialogue which I always remember somebody asked me बंदो तुम दिखाई नहीं देते क्या हो रहा है तुम खोई खोई लगते हो कहते हैं जी जीने का वक्त नहीं मरने का time नहीं that is the pressure he had So I hope you have that pressure. The point is not. The challenge is when you go to industry, you have to manage complexity. When you say complexity, see studying five subjects of this five chapters of the same subject is easier than studying five chapters of five different subjects. So how do you manage complexity? So ability to manage complexity is to be developed. Because so many things. I was talking to the MD of Dabur. He's a He was with me in program. He's become the youngest MD of CEO of Dabur. He says the number of things you have to handle, media, press, equity investors, customers, government, the complexity only increases. So I'm not talking how many hours you work, but ability to handle various challenges together at the same time. So, you know, one of the ideas of management education is to put people under different pressures, because that's a training. So it's not that is going to do them. So you're managing complexity. You know, I was from a Jodhpur university, at my engineering, to kya hota tha, bhi ek exam hai, do din ka, break hai ka, fir agla exam hoga. Went to IIM Calcutta, ki ek paper abhi 9 baje hoga, class ho rahi, 10 baje, surprise test, usme zero aa gaya. Because surprise test ka surprise hi hai. So managing complexity. So I don't know whether we put that much pressure on managing. नहीं एग्जामिनेशन नहीं, वो कभी भी एग्जाम हो सकता है. सो यू आर गुड इन मैनेजिंग कॉम्प्लेक्सिटीज, है गुड, बिकॉज दिस इज वन थिंग यू हैव रियलाइज, मैनेजिंग कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी एंड देयर डिफरेंट फोर्सेस एक्टिंग ऑन यू एंड दैट इज अनदर चैलेंज व्हिच यू हैव इन मैनेजमेंट. देयर आर टू फोर्सेस एक्टिंग ऑन यू, वन इज शॉर्ट टर्म बेनिफिट एंड वन इज शॉर्ट टर्म नो बेनिफिट, लॉन्ग टर्म बेनिफिट. So there is a law in physics called the law of parallelogram of forces. Have anybody heard of this? Law of vector forces. Yeah. You couldn't have done engineering without doing physics. You couldn't have done physics without learning like law of vector forces. Now, can I pick up people? Have you heard of this law? Law of vector forces or law of parallelogram of forces? I believe yes. Yeah, tell me. Huh? He's answering. Yeah. Come, you can answer, ma'am. Young man. Very good answer. Please give him this chocolate. See, problem is, usme kya kehte hai? The law of parallelogram forces says, if two forces simultaneously act on an object and represented by the two adjacent sides of parallelogram, then the diagonal drawn from the point of contact of these two forces measures the resultant both in intensity and in direction. I don't know if my definition is right or not. And the formula went something like R is equal to square root of u squared plus v squared minus 2u cos theta. U and v are the forces and theta is angle between the two forces. Galat hai, don't tell me galat hai. I just said something which I remembered. So my point is, there are solutions to it. Because aapko resultant dekhna hai, jahan se force jata hai, jahan se angle hai. But in life, you know what happens is, you have sometimes enough forces acting on you. In corporate world mein, a lot of people get into problems because they want to get the short term right. In sales marketing, what happens? Your dispatched vehicles, your dumped vehicles, because why is the auto industry suffering now? It's not that industry is in a very bad shape 3 months. Because auto industry dumped stocks when it was not required. Ab itna stock ho gaya ki aank se nikal raha hai, kaan se nikal raha hai, sir se nikal raha hai. Now they have to cut production. And now there is major thing. So short term versus long term. Boss will get angry, they will not happen, nobody will notice, time nikal jayega, increment mil jayegi. You know, these are the typical things in corporate world. And whenever I've seen, whenever you forgo long-term perspective lens in the interest of, it's a saying, whenever you sacrifice long-term interest on the altar of political expediency, politicians do it, na? Everything short-term, vote take politics, it harms you. And sometimes the long-term harm is not long-term, it happens quite fast. Should I give you one example of failure of this, my personal failure? Failure, बड़ा खुश हो रहा है मेरा failure का सुन दे. You know, we were not getting a dealer in Chennai. So our MD called us, me and the All India sales head. I was head of strategy development, dealer development. I know what you people are doing, yaar. Chennai, we need a dealer. The two dealers are left. Hyundai is so strong. What are you doing? Ye, wo, I know nothing. Get a dealer in 30 days. So हम दोनों बाहर आए. And we are all like 20 years experience. कह रहा हूँ dealer Chennai में मिल तो रहा नहीं है. चलो चलते हैं Chennai. We took a flight from Delhi to Chennai. घूमे फिर भी नहीं कोई खास मिले. वी गॉट अ डीलर हु वॉज टर्मिनेटेड बाई हुंडई, जिससे मिला कहीं. तो हमने बोला इसको टर्मिनेट किया हुंडई ने. वी आस्ट हिम, वेंट टू जस्ट मेट हिम. ही सर साहब, देयर वाज लॉट पॉलिटिक्स इन हुंडई, सो आई टर्मिनेटेड मी, आई एम वेरी गुड. वी न्यू इट इन आर इंटरेस्ट कि दिस गाय हैज डन समथिंग मेजर रॉन्ग, दैट्स व्हाई हुंडई इज टर्मिनेटेड. बट व्हाट वी वर सीइंग वाज कि इसका बना बनाया इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है, बना बनाया शोरूम है, स्टाफ है, MD हमारे पास गुड गर्न लगा के खड़ा हुआ है. एक महीने, एक दो महीने की बात दे रहा है, ये तो 20 दिन में स्टार्ट हो जाएगा. ही इज फ्री, आई डोंट हैव टू ऐड इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. सो हमने उसको अपॉइंट कर दिया, बड़े खुश होकर आए. MD ऑल्सो गिव अस अ बैक, ओ ग्रेट अरुण डन, ग्रेट अरविंद डन, बड़े खुश हुए. 6 मंथ के बाद उसने बड़े फ्रॉड शुरू कर दिए हमारी कंपनी में, धड़ाधड़. and we had to terminate him. And 1 year later, we were back on the streets again. और जो झाड़ हमें MD से तब पड़ी उसका तो कोई जवाब ही नहीं हो सकता. So you know, two people with 20 years experience, with all the intelligence of the world, with all the contacts, we could have checked up anything. We didn't want to check up. हम देखना ही नहीं चाहते थे reality. There's a saying ना, if you don't look at the tiger won't look at you. ऐसा होता नहीं है. It's better look at the tiger. And we got caught. So whenever you are sacrificing, and this is in your professional career also, short term को चीज को focus कर रहे हो over long term, it is doomsday. It is the recipe of doomsday. And this is one example which Gavaskar, now I met a lot of cricketers, you'll speak envious, he काम क्या करता था, कभी cricketers से मिलता था, कभी साक्षी मलिक से मिलता था. I didn't tell you I met Dia Mirza also, that's another story which I won't tell here. So Gavaskar said one thing, I was telling him that, you know, yeah, you played cricket when Lilly, Thompson, all these top cricketers were there and you bowlers were there and you still never wear a helmet. एक छोटी skull cap पहनते थे यार. आजकल के तो astronaut बनते हैं पूरे बन के आते. He said one line which I never forget. He said, one of the things which I did, and he was not very athletic. Gavaskar is 5 feet 6 inches, not the most athletic type. He says, I never took my eye out of the moving ball. Lot of people when they duck, they take the out eye away from the ball. And then they get hit. So I never took my eye. So a lot of time when we face uncomfortable situation, we don't want to look at it. मेरा होता था बचपन में था जब बहुत चक्कर हो जाता था कुछ पंगा हो जाता था टेस्ट में फेल हो जाता था तो मैं चार आलू के परांठे खा के सिर पर रजाई ले लेता था कि चलो नींद भी जल्दी आ जाएगी भूल जाऊंगा. दैट वॉज माई वे ऑफ डकिंग रियलिटी. आई मीन एज अ स्कूल चाइल्ड द अदरवाइज एवरीबडी हैज डिफरेंट स्टाइल. माई स्टाइल इज आई ईट टू मच. वैन आई गेट अंडर प्रेशर आई ईट टू मच. सो वैन यू ईट टू मच यू गेट टू गेट स्लीप फास्टर. नो आई एम नॉट रिकमेंडिंग दैट कोर्स टू यू बट दैट वॉज माई कोर्स ऑफ एक्शन. So my point is, when how do you short term versus long term and not being out of touch with reality? Reality, how bad it is, face it front on. Weaknesses, how bad they may be, face it front on. All these things are softer things which are a management career. Do you agree or not? Dusra kya hai, when we are talking of a brand, remember your corporate career. All the things which I am saying, you have to start acting on it today. They can't be acted tomorrow. The earlier you act on it, the better it is. Who was the founder of the famous founder of Apple who died of cancer? Steve Jobs. You know what was Steve Jobs' biggest failure? He was so engrossed in his job and his career that he was having a pain on his head and something, and his friends were advising him that why don't you meet a specialist? He said, I have no time, I have to do the products to develop, I have to launch. And when he went for the diagnosis, his cancer was second stage. The best doctors of the world were called to cure him. But the cancer had crossed second stage. All the money, all the wealth, all the fame, all the best doctors of the US could not save him. He died at the age of 48. So, the moment you do things younger age, cancer is a very wrong example to give, but I'm saying you are able to improve on it faster. So, all these values which I'm talking of, and this I've observed, these are common skills or lack of actual this thing. You have to start practicing in some way or other. Do you agree with me or no? Bole yaar bol raha hai yaar bolna hai. Aisa to nahi ho raha. You know, I am telling from my heart what I have seen. So that's important. Then brand hai. I don't know how what happens in the corporate world. You know, it's a very interesting thing. You are a junior person. You think senior ko kaise pata hoga mere baare mein. I don't know what way it happens. And there's nothing to do with social media. I realize one thing. That seniors somehow knew. There some people who were very good in ki boss ki champi maar lo, sifarish kar lo, unke bachcho ko music sikha do. You know, there are a lot of people who specialize in these areas, used to specialize. I don't know now they do or not. Hamare time mein hote the. Chota mota gain hota tha unko. But the real people who gained were who were good in their job. That's one thing I've realized. And I'm not talking moralistic. So, you know, how do you... You are a brand. I have seen examples when I was a senior level. So, there are 7-8 junior people. They have to be rotated. So we are at general manager, vice president level. There are people who are deputy manager level. So, and we don't know these people very well because we are 3 levels above them. But somehow the best people and the worst people get identified very faster. I don't know what is the system. Best ke baare mein sabko jaldi pata lag jata hai, worst ke baare mein. So there will be some people who are bad. So everybody is saying his friend Kohli. No, you take him yaar. I don't need a person. You take him additional. So koi kisi ko free de raha hai, toh usko panga hai, koi problem hai. So, and there's some person, farm friend will fight, no, I need this person. They'll create enmity. I fought with my colleague or he's fought with me for one person. We didn't talk 2 days. Now that shows that is the brand of the person. Somebody has built such a strong brand that people are fighting over him in the same company in the outside world. Today placements hoti hain, people in the change industry, balki aajkal to aur bhi easy ho gaya hai. Everybody's image is known and not at the senior level. So you are a brand and what you invested in the brand, log kehte na, nobody is watching me. But somehow the law of probability, people are watching you. So how you have built your brand, how you have built your image, and this will not get be built overnight. This can't be built by one or two quick actions. This has to build by sheer output and work. People see you as innovative, people see you as hardworking, people see you as creative, people see you as questioning. And I've realized one thing. People respond to those people. If I was in dealer development in the head office, somebody I've asked information, he'll respond faster. It is my moral responsibility, I will respond to him faster. So I will respond to him faster because he responded to me faster, he or she. So this is something how you are building. So I'm saying each one is a brand. Who is the best brand guru of the world? A marketing mein ho, management mein ho, who's the best brand guru of the world? Huh? Somebody said Ramdev? But his brand has got diluted now with his quality issues. Anybody else? Huh? Brand guru means not that he's Kopna brand, but he's promoted some brand which is unique. Think of it, yaar. It could be anything. Ye thoda logon ka jawab zyada chahiye mujhe. I need more people to answer questions. Huh? Speak loudly, yaar. No harm. Prasun Joshi, yes, he's a creative person. You know, to me, who's the best brand guru? How many of you have seen the film Sholay? Oh, a lot of people have seen. How many have not seen Sholay? Achha, and how many have not heard of Sholay? Everybody has heard of Sholay. Oh, I call Ramesh Sippy as the biggest brand guru of the world. And why do I call him the best brand guru of the world? In his movie, there were big characters like Dharmendra, Amitabh Bachchan, Amjad Khan, Hema Malini, Jaya Badri. But there were characters who came for two minutes in the movie. Can anybody name me these characters? What were they? In the film, they came for 2 minutes, 4 minutes. Huh? Samba. Or? Huh? Kalia. Huh? Jailer. Angrezo ke zamane ke jailer. Huh? Or? Huh? Ramu Kaka, huh? Mossi. Now here I am talking of certain people who came in the movie in 1975. Anybody born in 1975 yahan par? First row ko chhod ke, ek do Brazil ko chhod ke. Now imagine Surma Bhopali, Angrezo, he created individual brands, clear identity. 75 is, we are in 2019. We are 44 years down the line and this young generation was born. Average age kaha hai iski batch ki kya hai? 25 hai, 24 hai? Huh? So you are born 24 years before the movie was released, after the movie was released. So still remember those characters. That was the power of branding, differentiation. Each character was unique. So that even this generation, where you forget movie, kaun murderer tha, kaun uska tha, you forget who died or he lived. So you remember, that was the clarity. So you know, whenever you communicate, how clear is your communication that you become Ramesh Sippy? The identity is very clear. You cannot understand it. People say, "Maine bola kuch na suna kuch." Aisa nahi hota hai. There is a communication when you communicate very clearly and precisely. Jo aap bolte ho, wahi sunta hai dusra. And you can always cross check up what you said. Do you understand or not? So that's the power of clarity and simplicity of communication. Yaad rakhna, corporate life is not a T20 match, neither is a 100 meter dash. It is more like a marathon race or a test match. Anybody is a marathon runner here? Haanji, you are a marathon runner, please get up. Mini marathon runner? Abhi khada ho jaiye. Nahi, main daraunga nahi aapko yahan par. So don't have to fear, because there's no way I can check with you a marathon runner or not. So I'll ask a question. A marathon race mein kitni outer distance hota hai? 42 Chalo, give him a big hand. Yes, yes, yes. Sorry. So, sir, please sit down. So, you know, corporate life is like, you know, a lot of people are worried. You know, now I'm coming to the most basic thing, the job market. There is so much pressure, so much. I used to go for placement. I'm 4-5 saal pehle, abhi to nahi gaya hu. Jo logon ke tension phase pe hoti thi placement time mein, lagta hai ki duniya khatam ho jayegi. Ya is paar hai, us paar hai. Hiroshima Nagasaki ka bomb gir jayega ya zinda reh jayenge. I know it is important. But let me tell you, it is not the most important thing. Now you're saying, yaar ye to dil bilane ke liye baat hai, Ghalib ki dil bilane ke liye baat gyal achha hai. Lot of people are so much focused on placement that if it doesn't happen to their liking, they think duniya unki khatam ho gayi. They become like Gurudat ki duniya mujhe ab khatam ho gayi, mil bhi jaye kuch nahi hai mere liye duniya mein. Please remember, the corporate world is a marathon race. I've seen many people from very low management institutions. Yours is a good institution. They have done better than people from the best institution, and they didn't get the best start. So you know, it's like more like a marathon race. The world does not change. You should try for your job, but don't get enamored by it so much, or don't get influenced by so much that the world will change. Anybody from placement here? You know, there's too much pressure building on placement. Media builds it up, peers build it up, uska 1 plus crore ho gaya, usko 28 lakh mil gaya, usko ye mil gaya. Second part, are you being guided when you take up, apply for job, by your passion or what the world thinks of you? Some jobs people are applying just because if I get that job, mere tie upar hai, mera coat upar hai, main sab kuch upar hoon, mere pe sir pe taaj hai. And this is a very illusionary thing. If your passion, if your interest, if your attributes required for the job don't match you, you may be happy, but you will suffer. I don't know whether you see a YouTube video of the person who will make my trip. Who's made make my trip? Who's the owner? You know the promoter? Huh? Deep Kalra. Huh? So he said something in an interview, and I met him also. He said, I was from Stephen, so people told me the bank jobs are the best. He said, I was miserable 3 years. I realized it didn't interest me. He gave us a job without having anything in hand, and he started his own company, and that's history, make my trip. So, you know, a lot of people don't hear the inner voices. Dunia kya kahegi, friends kya kahenge, colleagues kya kahenge, parents kya kahenge, neighbors kya kahenge. I'm not saying you should not aim for the best jobs, but please, first of all, the world does not end with the job. And second, please don't just follow CTC. ये CTC है ना, इस become a very dangerous word. तेरा क्या, मेरा क्या, CTC. CTC is discussed a lot. Yeah? And be careful how the CTC are look. Some companies ना just chair AC चलाते हैं, उसको भी CTC में add कर देते हैं. Or they give the highest possible incentive. So when you realize you think you're 28 lakh, when you go, you find it's 20. So this is another catch I've seen. A lot of these multinationals, and you know, especially ESOPs wale, they are very expert in this. Go through it carefully. Some of the conventional companies don't do these tricks. And people, they find after 1 year. My point is, first of all, follow something which is your passion or you have interest in. You know, where is the highest attrition of the best engineering graduates, best MBA graduates? The McKinsey's and the KPMG's and the Nomura's have the highest attrition after 1 or 2 years. Because people realize that is not the job I wanted. Because it was the most happening job. 26 lakh CTC mil raha tha, ye hai, 5-star hotel from day one, traveling abroad. But agar dil khush nahi hai, and you don't, because you have to manage outside world, you have to manage skills, you have to sell, and there are certain skills required, which sometimes you can crack the interview. You can crack the interview in some manner. So my only advice to you is, if you follow something which is your interest, you will always do well. If you follow something which the world thinks is good, but it doesn't in your inner heart, you know of it, don't do it. It'll boomerang. It's a short-term versus long-term approach. And the world does not end with the jobs. The world is a long player. I mean, 1 year, 2 years doesn't make a difference. I tell you where the real differentiation in the career starts happening is after 10 to 12 years. Then the gap starts rising. It's like saying, you know, in the army also, everybody becomes a captain, major, and after that the gap starts rising. In the corporate world also. If your fundamentals are good, if your domain is good, if you're in an inquisitive mode or you're always in a learning mode, and you have the ability to emotionally connect. The most successful person in our batch is a gentleman called Anand Kripalu. He was the Asia brand director of Cadbury's Asia Head 12 years back. जब मैं सिर्फ जीएम था या सीनियर जीएम था 14 इयर्स बैक, हिज बिगेस्ट कनेक्ट वॉज ही वुड टॉक टू एवरीबडी, ही वुड लिसन टू एवरीबडी, ही वेंट केम फॉर द रियूनियन. नाउ इज सच अ बिग मैन बिकॉज नाउ इज नाउ जो यूनाइटेड ग्रुप है जो विच इज मालियाज ग्रुप हैज बीन सोल्ड टू समबडी, सो ही इज हेडिंग द एंटायर ऑपरेशन. आई डोंट नो व्हाट सैलरी इज इन. ही केम, ही सॉ द जेंटलमैन हु यूज्ड टू सर्व अस चपातीज इन द कैंटीन, की उसने एक खाना था. अरे यार तुम वही हो, तुम मीर के असिस्टेंट हो ना, इधर आओ यार, क्या है वैसे ही चपाती बनाते हो. दैट इज हिज पर्सनल टच स्टिल. ही इज व्हाई हैज टू टॉक टू द मीर वाज आवर चीफ कुक, और उसका भी एक असिस्टेंट होता था जो अब शायद मीर की जगह लेके, तो वो नहीं हो, हिज टच विद रियालिटी. सो प्लीज पीपल हु आर टच विद रियालिटी, वन ऑफ द थिंग्स विद लेक्चर्स विच आई एम डूइंग नेक्स्ट वीक इज द कर्स ऑफ सुपर सक्सेस. लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु बिकम वेरी सक्सेसफुल दे लूज टच विद रियालिटी. Can you give names who are very successful but something has happened and they are finished? I don't want to give names, I don't want to be quoted. Huh? Who? Kapil Sharma, chalo, he still come back. Huh? Mac Tyson. Mac Tyson, sports se nikal jao, come to the business world. Chalo, okay. What else? Huh? Okay. I want looking one or two very different names. There was one gentleman, have you heard of Rajat Gupta? When we were growing up in MBA, he was a role model for every MBA person. Because he rose from a middle class background, cracked his IIT, joined McKinsey at 23 and 46 ki age mein, 20 years back, he was the chairman of the worldwide McKinsey. And what he did after that, after McKinsey leaving, he used to pass the simple secrets what's discussed in private confidential meeting to his friends. And then he was imprisoned for 8 years. So the most successful Indian executive ever in the career was in jail in US for 5 years. And now he's written a book to redeem himself. Although many people don't believe him. Chanda Kocher. How could she not know that the conflict of interest, business interest? She's such a sharp lady. I have interacted with her 15 years back. And I predicted she'll become an MD of to my colleagues. She was that bright, that sharp, that still. How can she not know? So, you know, sometimes when you get success, you get surrounded by hanger-ons or yes-men. I call it the syndrome what Rajesh Khanna had. Kaka tusi great ho. Rajesh Khanna was a much better actor than Amitabh Bachchan. Much better actor, much more talented, much more successful, much earlier starting. But he lost out. So, par aap kuch log bol gaya, pehle main successful to ho jaun, fir tumhe curse of super success ki baat karu. But let me be super successful. But I mean, the point is be in touch with reality. And some of these people have made the blunders which are the even people with half, one tenth of the IQ, one tenth of the experience would not make. Stupidity. So you have to warn against that which is there. Do you agree or no? So I'm coming to the last part. I think we are running out of time. I have lost track of time. Kya kitne baj gaye hain? Huh? Oh my God. Kisne bataya nahi mere ko, huh? So, the last thing I want to say is, do not jump to conclusions. I mentioned example. Pause, think back and take your decisions. Listen to everybody, but ultimately apply your mind. Sometimes we act on spur of the moment. My worst decisions in my career have been when I acted on impulse, spur of the moment. That's something which is there. And one thing which I'll end with, which is the best share to invest in today? Huh? Yourself, you're right, but best share to invest is your health. Nowadays people, because of the eating habit, drinking habits, odd hours, pressures, they are causing a lot of problems to their health. And I've seen a lot of mid-level executives at 30 or 40, the ailments which are there, it's unbelievable. So invest in health doesn't mean only weight. Health means a sound thing. That is the best investment you can make in life. I'll just end with a personal story on this, on health. And this story was told to my father, who expired 4 years back. He used to study in Agra Medical College in the late 50s. And once the news came that Raj Kapoor is going to pass in an open jeep, who was a superstar at the time, outside the college. So he and his friends climbed on a tree to get a glimpse of Raj Kapoor. And he came half an hour baad, dekha, haan, Raj Kapoor ki jhalak mili, chala gaya. Cut 1987, Raj Kapoor was serious, a patient under my father in All India Institute of Medical Sciences. And when my father, he says, whenever he used to go to the room, and he knew Raj Kapoor, my father was a doctor treating him, so usko injections lag rahe the, kahi ho rahe the, he died after that. He used to cry like a baby and he started touching my father's feet. Doc saab, injection mat lagao, bahut dard ho rahi hai, ye hai. He had gained 30 kg weight, he had blood pressure, cholesterol, everything, and he was hardly 64. Rishi Kapoor wanted to take him on an emergency ambulance to USA. He asked my father, he said, usko kahin le jao, koi ek organ to theek chal raha ho. He had no discipline in life. He did not invest in his health. And he had no chronic or you can say a hereditary problem. He died at the age of 64 in spite of the wealth test thing. So that story always I remember. Climbing a tree to get a glimpse of a person and the other person crying like a baby and touching her feet. To me, that's the fine holistic health. Thank you very much. Any questions? 2-3 questions which you have because I've been talking, which are there. Any questions which you have, any doubts, questions, criticism, anything. I want some tough questions to be asked. I want to be challenged. Maine aapko challenge kar diya, kahin ko yahan khada diya, kahin ko bitha diya, kahin ko rula diya. So I also want to be challenged. Yeah, please. So, you know, this is a typical problem I also face and I haven't changed it, but the best thing is keep noting down, measuring it. The moment you start taking noting, it's like saying that if you take your weight every day, suppose you have reacted once, wrote every day line, take out the notebook. If you see it 40 times, it will hit pressure on you. Otherwise, you'll always rationalize it. Nahin, usne aisa ho gaya, usne mujhe incite kar diya. So, you know, we have a human habit of rationalizing things. Note down your things you're doing wrong on a daily basis. Don't write down things you're doing right. It helps. Anything you write, you remember. And anything you write in your hand, it hits you back and read that book again. That's the only thing I can suggest. I tried this, didn't succeed 100%, but helped me 30%. Yeah.
Sir, taking an example, you are working in an organization and now you have an option of doing the work in your comfort zone and going out of your comfort zone. Now we know that if you are in your comfort zone, you can give your best. And that will be best for the organization. And if you go out of your comfort zone, then there are fair chances that you might fail. So there you will see first for yourself, for your learning or for the organization.
So you know, there are two things. One is taking up a totally different assignment. The other is in your own assignment, pick up projects which people don't want to touch. I'll give one example. My best success is only one in life. Suzuki has a plant in Pakistan. Japanese were going and training Pakistanis. They all failed. They offered it to Indians. Nobody raised their hand. I said, I will go to Pakistan and train people, the dealers and this thing. So people said, dimag kharab ho gaya. Pakistani wale Indian ko kaise sunega? I said, no, I will do it. Sab pata hai, janoon tha, pagalpan tha. So my wife asked me, yaar, tum Pakistan ja rahe ho 10 din ke liye. Main kya kare, naukri hai. Boss ne zabardasti bhej diya. Ye nahi bola ki, I had offered myself. So, and things which I couldn't do, the training which I could give to the Pakistan dealers and this thing, they still remember me. Aaj bhi Pakistan se mere ko 15 phone aate hain. Raw ke bhi phone aa gaye ek do, isliye I'm not, don't pick up those calls too many. My point is, in your own job you can search out areas. And I got my fast promotion that year because the chairman of Park Suzuki was Japanese, wrote to the chairman of O Suzuki Japan and said, your person has done wonders. And I got my, that year my performance was very poor, but I still got a promotion that year. So I had moved out of comfort zone. Nobody was ready to do it. And there was no risk much attached to it. I mean, I didn't succeed. See, please, when you move out of comfort zone, the expectation on you also are low. Take, in your own assignment, take up something out of your comfort zone. Even what you're doing, forget a different job. It helps. Or even if you fail, you develop new faculties. You develop new ideas. You develop new toughness or hardness. That's what they have. Your last question.
But
sir, taking my own example, I'm not bad at anything, but I don't find happiness.
Yeah, you're a lucky person, yaar. I'm bad in so many things. Huh? I don't find happiness
in anything, so I don't know what my passion is. What do I give in this question? I've stumped the question. There will be ranking in life. Mein. Are you married or not? So if you meet 7 girls recommended to you, you have to marry somebody, na? You can't say I'll marry all 7. Huh? So prioritize. See, there has to be intensity. Anything. think of examples. Think of real things. You know, when you say this is my passion, think, substantiate it with a logic and example. It will give you more insight. Because suppose you say, I am passionate on music. I'm just taking an example. Think of the two incidents which shows that your passion is unique. Passion is something where you are better than 95% people without trying too much and you still enjoy doing it. To me, that is passion. You don't have to make extra effort on passion. Because I thought I could convince the Pakistanis, so I took it as my passion. I can convince anybody. So why not Pakistanis? If I'm a marketing person, then Pakistanis, why can't I convince Pakistanis? Maybe Indian. That was my belief. Maybe wrong belief. Ho sakta fail hota, but I succeeded there. So think of examples. It will give you a better direction. The compass and clock approach. Look at the compass always. Clock sometimes 2-4 seconds peeche chale, doesn't matter. That's part of it. Last question, any one more? You know, one is talking of ethics from a moralistic point of view. But I have seen, you know, and let me not take the moral high ground. Ki bhai ye acha hai karna, this is good for your character. I have seen when you go, when you do unethical things, it puts you in a vicious circle. The example which I shared with you, appointing a dealer in Chennai, that was unethical. It was not taking money. Unethics doesn't mean only taking money or being corrupt. Ethics is you know professionally what is right and you still do something wrong. So, you have to take a view on that, and I believe companies which try short terms, they generally, they got caught in their own thing. I'm not saying you have to be Hadada Harishchandra, but somehow 90% of ethics should be correct. Your basic compass of ethics should be correct. That's what I have to say. And I've seen people rising, they are not the most scheming person who have risen. You think Azim Premji is a scheming person? You think Narayan Murthy is a scheming person? You think Anand Mahindra is a scheming person? You think R.C. Bhargava is a scheming person? No, they are not. I have interacted with them in some sense. Not with Narayan Murthy, but with at least people. They are people who have something where you start realizing the value. So that's what I have to say. Okay, thank you very much.